I was going to talk about Philip Zadina being placed onto the top line, but last night's Detroit Red Wings game against the Maple Leafs served a much different story than that. So let's go over that right here. Let's talk about Jake Muzzin, Anthony Mantha, and Andreas Athanasiou, because these three guys all got their physical presences very fulfilled in last night's game. It all started in the third period at pretty much the end of the game there, where Jake Muzzin, as the Leafs entered the Red Wing zone, where it's a 4-0 game already, it's a pretty out-of-reach game, and Muzzin enters the zone and he lays a pretty big-ish kind of hit on Maddie Bowie. And it is something that I look at and I'm like, okay, that's just a hit coming into the zone. It didn't look like a huge hit, in my opinion. It just kind of sent the guy out and Muzzin just kept going along after. But then, eventually, it's Anthony Mantha who enters the play afterwards. And he comes in, starts getting a few punches in there onto Muzzin, and all of a sudden he's kind of got Muzzin in a little bit of a headlock. Mantha has his left arm draped around Muzzin, and you can see he's trying to use that right arm to get some punches in. At the same time as this is happening, however, Muzzin kind of uses his left arm to hold onto Mantha's chest area. It looks like he's grabbing the jersey in front, and his right arm comes draped over Mantha's shoulder. So what you get in this situation is a scene where Mantha is latched onto Muzzin's head via his left arm. He's trying to use the right arm to punch, and Muzzin has his right arm hooked over Mantha, and his left arm is kind of grabbing him in the middle. Give it a few seconds, and all of a sudden, Jake Muzzin kind of loses his balance a little bit. His foot goes a little bit forward, and he kind of rotates. He starts to rotate, and he falls down. Remember that foot, though, because that foot going forward, rotating while he was falling down, knocks up into Mantha's foot, and it causes Mantha to fall down in the process. And like gears rotating in a cog-like system, Muzzin falling down and causing Mantha's leg to rotate causes Mantha to rotate and fall onto his head, and it doesn't look pretty at all. It looks like a really, really unfortunate situation for Mantha, who hits his head hard. We could be losing Mantha for quite some time after that. But a lot of people were talking about this one instance, both Red Wings fans and Leafs fans. There is a very large portion of each fan base that has a different sentiment on this scenario, let's just say. Now, first off, to get things clear, yes, Muzzin did not need to take him down, but you could say that he didn't intend to do that. You could bring up the argument that Muzzin just tripped, and that is a fair argument to make. In my opinion, it doesn't look like he intentionally used his foot to jiu-jitsu trip Mantha. It does look like he kind of lost his balance to me, but the damage was done by the fact that he had his arms linked over Mantha. And that to me makes sense because Mantha's just wailing at him. What's Muzzin supposed to do? Now, for Mantha's sake, yeah, I don't think he should have gone after the guy with 2 minutes left after a hit on Bowie that didn't look all too dangerous. He was kind of just wailing at Muzzin, and he did kind of hold on to him afterwards, so the fighting back from Muzzin does make sense to me. But in a game like that where it's already done, in my own personal opinion, it's not necessary to go after Muzzin in the way that Mantha did, which was come in, start wailing on him, and eventually get taken down because the guy loses his balance and takes him down with him. A lot of Red Wings fans were saying things like, okay, I was surprised that Mantha went after him, but where's the other retaliation from the rest of the team? That's why a lot of people were saying, okay, Dylan McIlwraith, the guy is in Grand Rapids, he would have stood up for this no problem. But to that, in my opinion, the fact that the game was already so out of reach puts a scenario like that just out of the realm of necessity. The game is already kind of done, and I don't think there's a point to go after the guys like they did in that scenario. But moving on, after this happened, we see a little bit later, Andreas Athanasiou, who comes in and he tries to do just the dumbest move I've seen in hockey in the most recent span of time. Alex Kerfoot has the puck and he's trying to start things out from his own zone. He kind of swoops around and he starts skating a little bit forward. Then Andreas Athanasiou charges at him. He charges at him and it's real obvious that that's what he's doing. Kerfoot kind of moves over to the left a little bit and as a result leaves his knee exposed on the previous position that he was at. And Athanasiou is still going. He's still charging right in there. And he kind of moves over to the side as well. All of a sudden, you see a scenario where Kerfoot dodges the hit, but there is knee-on-knee contact. Athanasiou is kind of sticking the knee out a little bit, and it doesn't look all too pretty. And traveling at the speed that he was at, you could tell that there was an intent to get contact there. Now, in my opinion, people are saying that, oh, he's going for a knee-on-knee hit. He's trying to get the knee in there. And in my opinion, it's fair to have an idea that that's what's going to happen, but in my mind, Athanasiou's goal in that scenario was to just go for a big hit. But the fact that Kerfoot kind of moved out of the way kind of put Athanasiou in a weird spot where he was kind of turning, trying to go towards the guy, but the knee was stuck out in such a way where in certain contexts and certain frames, it looks really, really bad. Still though, in my opinion, you don't do that, man. You don't do that. Same with the other thing where Mantha comes in. The game is pretty much over, and you're on the last place team in the league. In my opinion, Athanasiou did something that I don't think any hockey player should be willing to do, and I wouldn't be surprised in the slightest if he gets some form of discipline from that. I don't think what Athanasiou did was necessary nor smart, but at the same time, the fact that Athanasiou is standing up for his guys in some capacity, I believe is an inherently positive thing for this Red Wings team moving forward. It's just that the way that he did that was really, really bad. I don't think that was necessary at all, and that's why Hall came in after, and Athanasiou then took down Hall and got a penalty for it, so justice is served, but I would not be surprised in the slightest if there's extra discipline that comes out of that little play. So, bottom line here, I do think what Mantha did was unnecessary. Getting involved in Muzzin's face like that and grabbing onto him and trying to just wail at him. At that stage of the game, I don't think it's necessary. But I do understand that what Muzzin did in retaliation of that also could be seen as terrible as well. Grabbing onto the guy, hooking yourself into him, and then falling down and, whether intentional or not, using your leg as a little bit of a trip, a stool, to force the guy to fall down as well. Now, I don't know if that was intentional on Muzzin's part. It did just look really bad the way that Mantha landed, and that should not have happened in that scenario. It's just a really bad situation in general, and I don't want Leafs fans and Red Wings fans to start yelling at each other over who did what worse, because if we can all just take a step back and agree that this in its entirety was bad, we can just move on. Because the league will do its thing, hopefully the league will do its thing, and give supplemental discipline to Athanasiou, who just tried to take a run at Kerfoot that was really unnecessary in my opinion. But I just want to wish the best for Mantha. Sure, I don't think the guy made the smartest decision out there with 4 minutes left, but the fact that he did hit the ice pretty hard on his head is terrible. For Muzzin, if he gets supplemental discipline for taking down Mantha with what you could call a slew foot, but I'm not necessarily going to do that because it does look like he did just lose his balance and eventually had his leg tangle up with Mantha's leg as well. For Muzzin, I'm not necessarily too sure what's going to be there, but at the same time, what's Muzzin going to do, right? Mantha's holding on to him and he's laying it in on him. I don't think it would be possible for Muzzin to just sit there and let that happen to him without some form of retaliation. And you could say, oh, he started it with the hit. I don't think the hit was that bad. That's just my opinion. And you're free to disagree. And I'm looking forward to seeing the comments because it will be very, very heated. But that's my little two cents on it. Mantha, Muzzin, Athanasiou, just a really bad situation in general. It shouldn't have happened, and I think I'm just gonna stop talking about it before it gets too out of hand. This will probably be the only video I make on it. Let's just say that. Hope you enjoyed this video, Social.Trolls99, and bye.